Hi friends, welcome to biotechnologyexamsforyou.com. Today the topic of our discussion is how is recombinant insulin produced by recombinant DNA technology. At the end of the discussion, you will be able to understand why recombinant insulin development is a significant milestone in recombinant DNA technology. What is insulin? What were the previous sources? What is the protein structure of insulin? Steps in recombinant DNA technology for insulin production, vector and host used in recombinant insulin production, and how this protein is purified by affinity chromatography. We'll be discussing all these within 5 to 10 minutes. Please watch till the end for complete understanding. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing our channel. Why Humulin or recombinant insulin is considered as a significant milestone in recombinant DNA technology? As we all know, insulin is a hormone that regulates blood glucose level that is essential for normal functioning of life. It is a drug that is used to treat diabetes. For that, the previous sources were the insulin from cow and pig. For that, we isolated the pancreas. Inside the pancreas, there is a region called islets of Langerhans. Within that, there are beta cells that secretes insulin. We were using that insulin to treat diabetes. Now with recombinant DNA technology, we have this insulin gene inserted inside a bacterium, and bacterium act as mega factories synthesizing large quantities of insulin within bioreactors. This recombinant insulin is called Humulin. Recombinant insulin or Humulin is the first approved marketable drug developed through recombinant DNA technology. Large quantities can be produced within a short time as the demand for insulin is on a rise for treating diabetes. There is no risk of transferring infections, no allergic reactions associated with cow and pig insulin, no ethical issues, especially slaughtering issues concerning the use of animals. So all these problems are avoided with the development of Humulin or recombinant insulin. Now let us discuss the most important discovery that led to the development of this recombinant insulin. It was Frederick Sanger who discovered the structure of insulin. Insulin is a protein consists of two chains, A chain and a B chain. A chain is made up of 21 amino acids, whereas B chain is made up of 30 amino acids that is joined by disulfide bond. For this discovery, he was awarded with Nobel Prize in 1958. So from this discovery, we came to know that insulin is a very simple protein which is made up of 51 amino acids. Now moving into the steps in recombinant DNA technology. The first step is identification and isolation of gene of interest or DNA fragment to be cloned. Here our gene of interest is insulin gene. Second step is insertion of this isolated gene into a suitable vector. Then we need to introduce this vector into a suitable host. The process is called as transformation. Then we need to select the transformed host cell. Then expression of the introduced gene inside the host for producing our gene product or insulin in large amount. And finally, we need to purify the protein or insulin. Now let us move into the detail of recombinant insulin production. So just to remind you about our previous video on steps in recombinant DNA technology, you can refer that for more. Step 1. Identification and isolation of gene of interest. From where we get this gene? So we have cDNA library. Chemical synthesis is possible. PCR amplification is another possibility. cDNA library is widely used as it is devoid of introns. So that gene will be directly expressed inside a bacterial cell which doesn't have intron removal mechanism. The most common method adopted for insulin production is chemical synthesis of A gene and B gene. As we know that insulin is made up of two chains, A gene and B gene, so we will be chemically synthesizing A gene and B gene. Step 2, insertion of this isolated gene into a suitable expression vector. So in this case, our intention is to express that gene inside bacterium. So we have a plasmid vector. We have human insulin gene, the gene for A chain and gene for B chain. So we'll be using two separate cultures for A chain and B chain. Then using a restriction enzyme, we'll be making a cleave or cut inside the vector. And this gene is inserted into the vector, we'll be getting a recombinant DNA molecule, and finally the cut ends are sealed with ligase enzyme. Now we have a recombinant vector. We will be making a recombinant vector using A gene, and we'll be making a recombinant vector with B gene. Now we have a recombinant DNA molecule. Human DNA that is joined to bacterial plasmid DNA, forming a recombinant DNA. That is why this technology is called as recombinant DNA technology, or recombined. Two DNA from different sources are recombined to form a new DNA. As our intention is expression of insulin gene, there should be control elements like promoter. In the case of insulin production, normally the insulin gene is inserted close to a beta-galactosidase gene, forming a fusion protein later. Then there will be antibiotic resistance gene that is present in all markers for selection of transformed colonies. So there is a promoter sequence of E. coli, then a beta-galactosidase gene. By the side of this beta-galactosidase gene, insulin gene is inserted. We'll be in two cultures. In the first culture, we'll be having this insulin gene A subunit. In the second culture, to the side of beta-galactosidase gene, we'll be having insulin gene B subunit like this. So we will be getting a fusion protein later. Now step 3. Step 3 is introduction of this vector into a suitable host. The most common host is E. coli in the case of insulin production. Then now we have yeast, mammalian cell lines, etc. So we have our insulin gene that is inserted into a vector. This is our recombinant DNA molecule with either A gene or B gene of insulin. So we have introduced that into a suitable host, that is E. coli. So this is a recombinant vector inside the host with our gene of interest, that is insulin gene. So there are different gene transformation methods like electroporation, microinjection, calcium chloride mediated transformation, etc. You can refer our previous video on recombinant DNA technology for more. Now we have a genetically modified E. coli with our insulin gene. This process is called as transformation, transforming the E. coli with a foreign gene. So this is the case with insulin. So we have the recombinant vector with A gene in one culture, A gene in one culture, and we have the recombinant vector with B gene in the second culture. Step 4 is selection of transformed host cell. So after the transformation experiment, we will be having three types of colonies. First one, majority will be non-transformed bacterial cell, then transformed with unchanged vector, and the third one, transformed with the vector that is recombined or recombinant vector. So this is a colony that we need to select. So there are different ways by which we can select these. The first selection is by simply growing these in antibiotic containing medium. As this vector is having an antibiotic resistance marker, all the colonies that will be growing will be having this vector. The second step is to find out the colony that is transformed with unaltered vector, and to find out the colony with recombinant vector. So we have different methods like antibiotic resistance in selective medium, visible characters, assay for biological activity, colony hybridization, blotting test, etc. We have given a 5-minute video on the selection of transformed colonies. You can refer that for more. Step 5 is expression of insulin gene in the host. Now this protein is expressed inside the host. It is a fusion protein. As you can see, this is beta-galactosidase gene that is fused to the A insulin gene, A gene protein. So here you can see this is the beta-galactosidase gene with B chain of insulin. This is called the fusion protein. Now we have this recombinant vector inside the host, and it will express. It undergoes transcription followed by translation, finally forming the protein product. As here is beta-galactosidase gene, we can induce this transcription and translation process by adding the substrate of beta-galactosidase, that is lactose, ensuring efficient translation to form the protein. So this is one of the advantages of this recombinant fusion protein. Now step 6 is purification of the protein. So now we have in two different cultures, we have this protein, beta-galactosidase insulin A fusion protein. Here we have in the second culture, beta-galactosidase insulin B fusion protein. So this is what is happening. This gene coding the target protein, and this is a fusion protein. This is also called as tag protein, as a way of tagging the gene of interest. So we have a fusion protein lysing the cell, purifying the protein, and protein is passed through affinity chromatography column. It will be having an antibody to this beta galactosidase protein. So beta galactosidase will bind to this. So later we can elute this. So we have only this protein, that is beta galactosidase insulin fusion protein. This beta galactosidase gene, often this site is having residues like methionine. So we can use cyanogen bromide, which will cleave in the methionine, so that we'll be getting the purified protein, that is A chain and B chain separately. Here there will be a methionine residue, so that cyanogen bromide will cleave here, so that we'll be getting this purified A chain and B chain separately in different cultures. And the final step is this purified A chain and B chain is mixed in vitro in appropriate conditions to form this disulfide bond, finally forming the active insulin. So now we have in large fermentation tanks, this protein chains are produced, then further purified and produced in large amounts, and is marketed as Humulin. This recombinant insulin was first developed by Genentech, a company located in USA. Let me summarize. Insulin is a protein made up of two chains, A chain and B chain. So we are introducing this A chain gene and B chain gene in a suitable vector that is close to beta galactosidase gene to form a fusion protein. As our intention is expression, we'll be using an expression vector with a promoter sequence like this. So there will be other normal components of a vector, like selectable markers for, that is ampicillin resistance gene for selection of transformed colonies. So once we have this recombinant vector, we will be transforming that vector into a host cell by different methods, gene transfer methods. After transformation, the protein will be expressed. As there is beta galactosidase gene, this expression can be induced by adding the substrate of this gene, that is lactose. So we'll be getting a fusion protein, that is beta galactosidase insulin A chain or B chain fusion protein. Later, we need to cleave this beta galactosidase enzyme from this insulin A chain. This is often done by affinity chromatography, where we'll be passing this protein through a column. So this beta galactosidase gene will bind to antibodies that is loaded in the column, so that we'll be getting only fusion proteins, then that is cleaved using cyanogen bromide that cuts within methionine residues, so that this A chain and B chain protein will be isolated separately. This A chain and B chain protein is then mixed together in appropriate condition for the formation of disulfide bond, finally forming the active insulin. And that is about the formation of recombinant insulin by recombinant DNA technology. Hope you understand the process. Thank you so much for your support.